Каша.
Russian Dad here. Many people ask me, tell us about life, you know, in the Soviet Union. Today I want to focus on a larger topic. What is it like living in a totalitarian regime? Because I think this will apply, because there are some countries today on the planet that are basically run by dictators. Maybe people, by watching this video, will understand a little bit more the whole psychology and the dynamics in the totalitarian regimes, because these are following certain patterns. By the way, here's what's bugging me about the whole subject. I lived in the Soviet Union, and do you think I knew that I was in the totalitarian regime? Absolutely not. I was ignorant. I can only talk about this now, many years later. Why? Because I can look at the whole situation through the prism of time, having collected some life experiences. But back then, I did not know what was going on. That's a part of it, because fish doesn't see kind of the water it swims in. And so those people that live in the totalitarian regimes, they may not realize what the hell is going on, and I will explain to you why. Because you see, those governments, those dictators, they follow a certain playbook. So let's look at this playbook. The first thing they do is they start indoctrination very young. I remember being in elementary school, or maybe even kindergarten, okay? I was very young, but they already showed me this picture of this iconic capitalist fat, you know, wearing a top hat. He was exploiting workers. Right away they explained to me, this person owns the whole factory and he makes, I don't know, 50 times more than everybody else. And then, is it fair that he's exploiting those workers? No, it is not fair. Nobody explained to me that the fat capitalist, of course, is an entrepreneur who like created jobs for those factory workers. Nobody explains that to me. Nobody explains that to the children. They start them young. They write their books in order to indoctrinate children. So from the very beginning, they will get what the party line is. Number two, they control information. This is as old as the world. This is what propaganda is all about. Like Goebbels in Nazi Germany, what was his job? He was chief propaganda officer. You always put out information of the kind that you want your people to know. Those governments, because they control the news, they're able to just like suggest to people what they need to think. 7 by 24, people are bombarded with messages. And if you tell something to someone for probably 2 weeks, people will start thinking that it's true. If we start putting out messages on Facebook and the talk show host, if we say that there is a shortage of grapes in France, there's not enough grapes in France and the prices of vines are going up, like people will start believing you. I don't think it even takes very long. It probably takes a week or two, maybe maximum 3 weeks. Once people start hearing it from the media, oh my God, we have a huge crisis on our hands. There's a big problem in France because they're running out of grapes. Anyhow, I don't mean to make a joke out of this. I'm just saying, basically, they control the information. In the olden days, I remember my grandfather would sit next to this radio, okay, listening to the Voice of America, trying to get just a little bit of some information that comes from the other side. And what were the government agencies were doing then? They were putting out interference so that you could not hear the signal. Today, the governments are probably more sophisticated around the world, but controlling information is basically a very important part of being a dictator rule book. Number three, those dictators are incredibly good at knowing what is good for them and what is not. Like, they're not stupid. We wish that those dictators were these like weird low IQ idiot figures that are just bloodthirsty but not really smart. But that's not the case. They're usually smart, and also they're usually surrounded by smart people, unfortunately, that, you know, do their bidding. And so that third aspect, as I said, is this: they know what's good for them. I'll give you an example. In the Soviet Union, yoga was basically outlawed. You would think it's harmless. Like, what's the big deal about yoga? All right, so you assume some positions, savasana, pretzel-like, and you do the lotus. No big deal, right? It's just good exercise. No, no, no. These people understood very well. First, you will start doing physical yoga. Then you will start thinking deeper thoughts, consciousness and self. And maybe you'll start meditating. And before too long, you will forget that one true religion is what exactly? Marxism-Leninism. That basically there is only one God, Marx, and Lenin is his prophet. So you see, they were very good at picking up at what they should allow and what should be made illegal. Rule number four in the dictator playbook is you need to crush the dissent. You need to remove the dissent, okay? You need to remove those people that basically see the matrix. You need to make sure that those people are gone and they cannot poison minds of the rank and file ignorant individuals, you know, the great unwashed, the masses. Now, it takes many forms, of course. Under Stalin, the way they would remove this dissent is basically by showing up at 2 a.m., you know, on those Черный Воронок, Black Raven. Basically, they would show up, they would take the person at 2 a.m., and then this person would never be heard from again. In later years in the Soviet Union, they became more sophisticated. Maybe people wouldn't be killed, but one way or the other, they would find a way to shut people up. And so by removing people that sort of see the matrix, they're able to control minds, because nobody will know that anything is wrong. It's kind of like if the child is born in prison, if that's all they know, they would never start thinking, well, there is like this whole free world out there. No, they just know that on Tuesday they get cabbage, and on Thursday they get, I don't know, extra meat, and on Fridays they're allowed like extra 20 minutes of walking in the prison yard, and that's all they know. They cannot dream of some kind of another life. People that are starting to see, you know, the boundaries of the bubble are removed, or they're shut up one way or the other. Anyway, it's a sad subject because there are countries today on the planet that live under totalitarian regimes, subjected to all of those things that I have just described, and probably more. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that gave you at least a glimpse of what it's like living in the totalitarian regime. Please comment on this video. I'm sure people have different perspectives. I would love to hear what you think of this subject. As always, thank you very much. I really appreciate you watching my videos. Stay tuned for more. Like my page, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Good night.